Hi, and welcome back to The Deployment Guy, where we make Microsoft Intune a little less confusing, one tutorial at a time. So this is part two of our Windows updates and Intune series. Now, before we dive in, a quick apology. This video should be out a lot sooner, but between feeling like I've been hit by a bus, or as my wife calls it, just a cold, and battling with iPads and Intune, life got in the way. But we're back on it now, so let's crack on. Okay, so in the previous video, we spoke about update rings and the deferral periods for both quality and feature updates, and why I tend to set the deferral period for feature updates to zero. Now, you don't have to do this. You can set the deferral period to whatever number of days you want, and your devices will just get the latest feature updates. Now, personally, I prefer to use the feature updates blade as it does give you that bit more control. So I'll click into feature updates, and we'll select create. Select create feature update policy. We'll give it a name. So we'll call it TDG feature update. Now, under feature update deploy, you can see we've got different versions. So we've got Windows 11 version 24H2. If we drop this down, you can see there's older versions down there. Now, if you're one of those kind of people that do like to stay a version behind, you could select version 23H2. I will be mindful though that if you select 22H2 and you get new devices shipped to you, there's a good chance there'll come with a newer version of the OS. So in this instance, we'll select 24H2. So then we've got the option of make available to users as a required update or optional. I'll have to keep that control again, so I'm going to select required. Okay, where a device isn't eligible to run Windows 11, install the latest Windows 10 feature update. Yep, probably a good idea. Just to note as well that if your device does come with 24H2 and you set the feature update to deploy as an older version, it won't downgrade. So you can make your update available as soon as possible, or you can do it on a specific date. If you do it on a specific date, you can send it out to a pilot group and test it, and then once you're happy, create a second profile and then deploy it out to the rest of your devices. Or we can make the updates available gradually. This is where we can set a start date, an end date, and the number of days between each phase. So for example, if we had 100 computers and we set the days between groups, something like 7 days, it would do 25 computers, wait 7 days, then do another 25 computers, wait 7 days, and so on. I'll be honest, I'm not a huge fan of this based on the fact that you don't have any control of those 25 computers. And if it randomly selects all your directors and senior management devices in that first phase and it goes horribly wrong, you can imagine it's not going to look great for you. Okay, so in this instance, I'm just going to select make update available on a specific date. Then I'll go ahead and select 7th of March and select next. And then we can go ahead and deploy this out to our groups. So I'll select our staff devices group and then select next. I'll give that a refresh, and as you can see, that's our feature update, and under status, it says scheduled. Now, once it hits the date, which in this instance was the 7th of March, this status will change to in progress. And that's pretty much it for feature updates. As you can see, fairly straightforward. Okay, so when creating quality update policies, we've got a couple of options. The first is Windows quality update policy, which is what I'll show you first, and the second option is Expedite policy. So I'll go ahead and select quality update policy. We'll give it a name, so we'll call it TDG quality updates policy, and select next. Apply the latest CE quality updates for security. As you can see, this is grayed out and you're getting them regardless. The next option is when available, apply with Windows hot patch, which this is a new feature. You were probably seeing a bit about this on the internet recently. This basically applies a patch without restarting your computer. So, no more please wait whilst we update when you just want to shut down your computer and go home for the day. So, because I like being able to leave work on time, we'll set this to allow. And then next, we'll deploy this out to our staff and student device groups. Select next and then create. So the other option under Windows Quality Update is the Expedite policy. Now, in our update ring, you'll see that we have set our quality update deferral to 14 days. Now, obviously, if there's some sort of zero-day exploit and Microsoft releases a patch for it, it's probably not a good idea waiting 14 days. So with Expedite update, you can basically create a policy to push out certain patches that ignore the deferral period. So if we go back into the quality update and create a new policy, we'll give it a name. And under Expedite installation of quality updates, you can see we have three updates in here. We've got a couple of security updates and a Windows update from the 25th of Feb. So regarding the naming conventions for these updates, D tends to be your standard patch Tuesday update and B tends to be your security updates that are typically released at the back end of the month. So we'll go ahead and select the latest D update for Windows 10 and later. Okay, number of days to wait before restart. Up to you, but if it's urgent, we can select 0 days. Next, we'll deploy this out to our groups. So we'll select both the staff and student devices groups. Select next, and then create. Okay, so that's it for quality update policies and how to expedite certain updates, which, as you can see, is a pretty straightforward process. Okay, next up is driver updates, which is pretty self-explanatory what this does. So let's create a new profile and give it a name of TDG driver updates. Under approval method, you can see we've got a couple of options, manually approve or auto approve. So if we select automatically, then obviously they'll be approved automatically. From there, we can then select the number of days from release until your devices receive them. So you could then deploy this out to your device groups, and when the policy is synced, it will just pull in all drivers for all the models from the various vendors that you've got. However, if like me, you tend to be quite standardized and you tend to stick with the same vendors and models, you could create dynamic groups for your models and then create your driver policies based around these. So under groups, you can see that I've already created a group for the Dell Latitude 9410 laptops. If I select this and then select dynamic membership rules, you can see for property, I'm using device model, the operator is equals, and then the value is Latitude 9410. So if we go back to driver updates, create a new profile. We will name this TDG Dell Latitude 9410 driver updates and select next. Again, you can select auto approve or manually approve. I tend to have nightmares about dodgy drivers blue screening my entire estate, and also for the purpose of this demo, we'll just select manually approve and select next. And then from here, we simply deploy this out to the dynamic group for the Latitude 9410s that I've just shown you. Now, straight away, you can see it's showing a zero to review. As with all things Intune, these things don't tend to be instant. As you can see, if we click into it on the last sync, it needs to now go out there and collect the data from your devices. From experience, I will say this can take some time, but once it's done, it will present you with which drivers then need updating. Okay, so typically the device I was using had a clean build and had all the latest drivers installed already. So to trigger this, I had to remove the display adapter and let it sync again. So as you can see, we now have the one driver to review. And if we click into here, you can see it's the display adapter, which is the one that I had manually removed. So if we select it, we have this drop-down box where we can select decline or approve. So we'll approve this one, and then we have to give us a date on when it will become available to our devices. Now, let's say you've got numerous drivers. You probably don't want to go in there and approve each one. So you can select bulk actions, select approve multiple drivers, and then again, select a date when they become available. Then you select the drivers to include. As you can see, I've only got the one driver, but if you had a number of drivers that will be listed here, you can select them one by one. Then you select save, and then next. If you look in the other drivers tab, this tends to show you different revisions of those drivers. Typically, you'll also find your firmware updates in here as well. So if I now jump on that laptop and look under update history, you can see the last driver to install was an Intel display adapter, which matches the version that I deployed. So there we go, that's drivers. As you can see, process is pretty straightforward, no real dramas. So that's the end of the video. Before I go, it's only fitting that I give a big shout out to Microsoft MVP, Andrew Taylor, for giving me access to his lab environment. If you know Microsoft Intune, there's probably a good chance that you already know who Andrew Taylor is. If you don't, he's a genuinely great guy and the author of the Microsoft Intune cookbook, which, if I'm honest, is an absolute must for anybody working with Microsoft Intune. He also produces a weekly newsletter, which is filled with a wealth of knowledge provided by some amazingly talented and knowledgeable people. If I'm honest, it's something that I do look forward to every Friday when I'm at work. I will post the links to both his book and also his website in the description below, so please do check them out. If you haven't already, please don't forget to smash that like and subscribe button. This has been The Deployment Guy. Thanks for watching and see you next time.